Langen versus Akaren. These girls are playing for the positions 1 to 3rd place. This is Langen, Akaren, and Castores of Colombia. So yesterday we saw Langen lost 2-0 against Castores from Colombia. Still, everything is open. Any of the three teams can become the champion. But there's a little bit more pressure on Langen because if they want to win the cup, they need to win this game. And Akaren has proof that they have a great tactic. They are also very efficient in attacking and defending. And they seem to play quite calm and they can bring their game on to other teams. So Langen needs to be have a cold head and try not to let the pressure influence their game, so that if they can bring their game, then I mean
I
both
think
teams can win.
Langen and Karen are on the same level of experience
Definitely,
of
yes.
players, but I repeat, and we got a lot of feedback about our comments about Langen. We were told we were criticizing Langen too much. Please understand, we know a lot about these teams, this German team, and we know how good they are. And I'm not saying this ironic at all. They are an incredible team. Langen has incredible players in this team, and for me, Langen was the top team next to Akaren, and Castores is the top team in this Champions Cup 2016. And if we say we haven't seen the full potential unfolding of Langen, we win it with goodwill, and Langen is totally capable of winning this Champions Cup if they do what they can do, play the best on the water rugby we've seen in the world. So no criticizing here and no team bashing. We are absolutely behind Langen, and we think that they can win this Champions Cup, but they haven't shown the full potential yet in this tournament. This is what we say, and this is not criticizing. This is just saying, come on, Langen, put everything in the water you have and win all the games you have in front of you. Totally possible. So looking forward to this game.
I think it's not over yet. So the
No.
Not
game,
at all. No.
so that
No.
means if they have a high scoring game and something like that, and make the games like they did against Barcelona, which is a very strong time, and I would say it's but also for the audience outside, I get also personal quotes again overnight. Please note, we are not professionals to do that. We're doing this just for fun, to support this. The computer has still the switch to
Turn it
off,
off.
turn it off, and
Turn off the sound if you don't like what we hear saying. Do your own comments.
And on the other hand, we are doing this in English, as far as you might realize, and that's not our mother tongue.
Exactly.
So excuse us for this, that we don't find sometimes
The
the right
words.
words, and something like that, or we're taking over some sayings out of the sport events we know. Apologize for that and focus on the games.
Me too.
Focus on the games and what the people, the athletes doing in the water, and that is what we are basically here for.
Yeah.
We just entertain you, and if just the pictures is too boring. My personal respect, I have to say, Langen has an extreme high players. They are old experience, former national players, actual national players, young potential, prospective national players. So everyone has a international background. So if they do what they're focusing, I don't know why they're doing the clustering. I never do this in training. So why they was the pressure too high, or what is the circumstances? They were irritating what people told them, whatever. So that do it on the water.
Yes,
Yeah.
and I think we also see after some games criticizing critics about the referees. everybody here is doing this on the best way he can. I think every team is playing the best way they can. We doing our comments the best way we know and we can. The referees do the best we can. And if you can do it better, please feel free to contact us. We're open for critics, but this is how it is, and we love every team here, and we want the best team of the Champions Cup to win. And we don't care what nationality they are, we don't care what color they are, we don't care what language they speak. We want the best team in the Champions Cup to win. And this is the game, Akarin against Langen, Germany against Norway, and it's...
2 times 15 minutes, huh? We
yeah,
start already.
2 times 15 minutes. And Langen is already on the attack on the Akarin basket, but... they were on a heavy attack, and there was a mistake from number 6. She passed the ball on to an Akarin player, and Akarin is now on the attack on the Langen basket. This is looks to be going to be a fast game. We see both teams very agile and very fast moving, and Akarin is now in the closed corner on the closed side of the Langen basket, already a player waiting on the open side, but the ball carrier was tackled away on the surface, and we have already a cluster here which is dissolved quite fast, and now Langen is in ball possession trying to break free, one player trying to break free, but now she found a PlayStation to play the ball to, and we're moving through the pool, but the offense defense of Akarin is quite heavy, and Langen has to fight for every inch to get forward to the basket of the Norwegian players. And we're now at the close side of the pool in the corner. And from here, Langen will start their attack on the basket. We have a player on the middle of the pool, on the bottom of the pool, trying to go in on the basket, but stopped and tackled away by a Norwegian player. And we're now on the close side, again in the middle of the pool. This is fast and heavy, and this is the first chance for Langen to score.
Wow.
And they do! Very good!
Great
this was
job!
Perfect.
Exactly.
It's exactly how it should be. And
2 minutes into the game.
Let me say...
Congratulations, there were two national players. I think this
was
Michael Rossmann, which this way can play very intense, especially in such position. And it looks like she was covered by her sister Lena, and that was a very excellent attack from one side.
This is what we want to see from Langen.
And that's their capability.
Yeah, exactly. And this is what they can.
So, yep.
Now we have Akarin going forward, and there's a Akarin player attacking the goalkeeper from above. But the ball is down on the close side now. But the defense, I think, of Langen has no problems on this point with the attacks of the Akarin player. And we have a cluster on the surface. Langen recovered the ball, is under attack by Akarin. Akarin recovered the ball, and now we have no defense here and an attack from the close side, now on the open side, but the forechecking and defense of Akarin is quite strong, and they tackle away and grab away the ball from the Akarin players, but it's difficult for Langen to break free and get out of their dangerous zone around the basket, and the ball was recovered by Akarin again. Now we have two Akarin players coming from the close side. This is one dangerous moment for the basket, but Langen did quite good to save the to moment, but the pressure still goes on.
And that's a score for Akarin.
Wow, but it was...
that was a very hot goal. I mean, they created a lot of chaos.
Yeah,
around
it, the same style of attack we saw from Langen on the other side. I think both teams have the same level of experience, the same level of
this is so
player
much
force. This is a different game we see from Langen than we've seen before.
Yeah, I mean, the win against the Castores was so much clustering on the surface, and this is so much of a flow and swimming and concentrating and building up waves. It's so much nicer rugby to watch, and so much more fun and so much more effective.
Thanks to New Work for thanking us for our work. We're happy you like what we do here. Rossi, if you're talking about what we said about Langen, thanks very much for understanding. The result of the Aggie game will be online soon. We will update the page. And we are now in the middle of the pool. Akaren is in ball possession. That was an interesting pass just in the open pool area where no player was. And Langen was there was a pass from Akaren. And the player, Langen player was fast enough to recover that ball. But nevertheless, we see a lot of forechecking in the middle of the pool. That's what rugby is meant to be, not clustering on the surface, but a fast forechecking play in the middle of the pool where the decision is made which team has the possibility to attack. And now we see Akaren again on the pool of Langen, but the defense is ready, fighting off the first wave attack. Now here comes the second wave. Already a player is coming from the open side on the level of the goalie, and she's passing to the close side. This game reminds me a little bit of what we just seen from Ege against Finland. This is a fast, concentrated, focused game. Very well played by Langen here, and now they are counter-attacked. They try to break free, but we're in the middle of the pool on the bottom, and this is where the game happens now. Now Akaren recovered the ball, disturbed by one Langen forechecker when the close side of the Langen basket. Again, a Langen player tries to break through in the middle of the pool. Now they made it. We see one Langen player going for the basket of Akaren, but the other players of Langen take a little bit too long to be able to participate in this attack, and the ball is intercepted by Akaren.
This ball throwing of the Norwegian way is not really working out really good. I mean,
they hope for their own players to be in the offense, but there is a Langen player that are faster.
I mean, it's a very fast speed game, a lot of swimming, a lot of counter attacks. And this is the kind of game we want to see in the finals.
And this is a call from the referee. It's a free throw against Karen Krip to the mask. And already a Langen player stole the defense position of an Akaren player. We have a Langen player directly under the basket, but she has to go up to take a breath. And Karen is in the offense, stopped in the middle of the pool by the offense game of Langen. So this is really a back and forth, and totally reminds me of the game we've seen before. Incredible. Nice underwater rugby game we see here, and Akaren is going forward now again, tackled away to the surface by a Langen player directly above the Langen basket. And this is a dangerous moment. We saw this in the game before, where the ball dropped down and the Finnish player just recovered the ball and scored. So we have a cluster on the surface. That both teams should be aware they're not helping the game and their game if they have a cluster on the surface. So Langen recovered the ball, and beautiful in the sun, swimming into the shadow of the Akaren basket in the corner. And already Langen player is at the basket on the close side, and we see the attack coming from the close side here. Langen plays it, tries to place itself. We have a save, we have a goalie and a defender on the surface sometimes. They should go, one of them should go into the game. So currently Langen has more players to push on the basket of Akaren. So Akaren recovered the ball, is now attacking the Langen goal. We have 6 minutes left in this first half of this 15-minute game of the...
She missed. I mean, she just passed the ball to one of her playmates, and she didn't see the current attacker. She was on the close corner, and the partner was coming in the middle, but she was looking towards the basket and didn't see that the ball coming to her, so they lost the ball, and now we have a counter-attack from Langen.
This is really, from both teams, high-level underwater rugby. Beautiful to see, and the decision is made in the middle field which team can decide its way to the basket. And there are not enough Langen players now at the basket of Akaden. We see too many players on the surface. It will be difficult for Langen if they stay like this to put enough pressure on the Akaden basket. And the result of this is a counterattack from Akaden, almost without forechecking in the middle of the pool. And Akaden had an easy game to swim through the pool and is now attacking again on the Langen basket, tackled away on the surface. Langen has the ball now. Nice forechecking from Langen. They intercepted the pass and they lost the ball again and they recover the ball again. It's a back and forth and really a fast game here. If you consider the games of Langen before, and even Akaden is much faster than we've seen in the last games. Both teams upping their game and throwing in the water the best they can. And now we have Langen going for a counterattack against the basket of Akaden, but they are stopped immediately in the middle of the pool by Akaden players and are not able to swim through. First wave, now the second wave of counterattack is breaking through, and we have one player trying to push through to the basket. Now on the open side, there is one player, and again, too many players on the surface. There are no second waves coming in, and it takes a little bit too long for Langen
to get down
on the bottom of the pool to be ready to attack. It is possible for a Langen player, for one Langen player to score, but the chances are much higher if you have at least two, three players coming down in waves. And so Akaden recover the ball, and we are 1-2 meters in front of the Langen basket. But Langen again managed to, with their forechecking, to recover the ball. And this is they lost the ball again in front of their own basket, and Akaden tries to break through the defense, but is stopped by the forechecking, and it's a one-on-one fight now. Laced 2 meters in front of the Langen basket, and we have a breakthrough of a Langen player. She tries to swim to the basket, is stopped by the forechecking. Defense of Akaden is already in place, and the counter attack of Langen is stopped by Akaden at least 1 meter in front of the Akaden basket. And now we have an attack from Langen from the closed side on the wall. But already we see too many Langen players on the surface. If Langen wants to score in this game, now they have to have more players on the bottom, and it will be too difficult for them to break through the very massive defense of the Akaden players. Now we have Akaden players here coming in from the open side on the level of the goalkeeper, but tackled away by the defense. And that's it, end of first half. And
No, it's not end of first half. It's still 2 minutes to go.
Ah, okay, what's
there
the ball?
It is.
From the referee, sorry for this.
Some other thing.
You are extremely excited, Wolf.
I'm excited all the time. This is underwater rugby. I'm excited. I'm in love with underwater rugby, and I'm excited about it if I play, if I watch it.
And it's such a great display of rugby right now.
Yes.
This is what we wanted to see yesterday.
Yes.
I mean, it's
yes.
so nice to see the swimming, they went back and forward, the recovering of the ball. Really, I mean, this is fun to watch.
And that's what life is all about. You have to keep the blood flowing through your body and feel what you see. And this is our sport. This is the best way to present our sport, like we've seen in the game before, Ege against Finland. This is underwater rugby, how it should be played. And
very clean, almost
yes.
no fault.
Yes.
I mean, they concentrate
yes.
on their game
yes.
and they try to stay focused, move the ball around. And yeah.
And both team, it's a back and forth, and both team trying to find the mistakes of the other team, but there are not many mistakes as in the game before Ege against Finland. And Langen is doing a good job, but they should manage in this case, being more massive with more players at the Akaden basket. Now Langen tries to break through to the Akaden basket or from the closed side. The players in the middle of the pool, 1 meter in front, fighting with the Finns of the defender, of the current defender, and we have now an attacker from Langen trying to get in on
pushing
the goalie.
Pushing without ball.
Pushing without ball, call from the referee, and it's a free throw against Langen. 20 seconds left, and I think we will see this first half of this game, Langen from Germany against the current from Norway, see as a equal, as 1-1. Wow, I'm impressed and I'm totally awake right now. Thank you very much. All three teams we've seen today
have been amazing.
It was Firenze against Vienna. First game today was a very nice game. Finland against Egge was great, and now we see Langen against Karen, and it's a great game to watch. Thank you very much. And we have to look into the camera.
So, if I would say something to the game, I would recommend Langen to get more goals in the offense under the water to support the attacks. So this is, I think, the important
essential here
essential
in this game. Yes.
Essential
yes.
for the game.
Totally agree.
To put more pressure on the Norway's basket. I don't know why. It, of course, it's the pressure is high. The
yes.
The potential.
Okay.
Applauding to all the teams here in the Champions Cup. Yes, again, we are not criticizing Langen. We're just telling what we see. And if Langen attacks with only one player against a formidable defense of a current.
I mean, we saw it on the goal they did. I mean, it was
yes.
two of them on the water, pressuring at least two, ideally three. Because Akaren, they are very experienced players, and they have been defending their alone attacks. And so far, I would say Akaren has got the possession of the ball a little bit more than Langen. At the beginning, they start quite equal, and then it built up so that Akaren had a little bit more possession of the ball. And but also, the thing that I'm surprised about Norway is they were
nice
to play
so
it often to make a speed game. But a little bit more safer play than that, just throwing the ball and hoping that the next player is going to come. Because I've seen this game by Norway, and it has worked in the past better than now. I mean, I haven't seen that they lost so many balls like in this game, even if they recover back.
I think also when Langen defend and get the ball, they need a strong counterattack.
Yes.
Not the way to the surface. They should try to speed up on the bottom of the in the pool to go in front.
I
and
see
that I know it's hard. That is
absolutely.
We are not saying
it's easy.
It's easy
no,
to do so something like that.
But I think the attacks of Akaren are more aggressive,
yes,
more dangerous on the goal of Langen.
You have two or three of them
yes.
going the counter-attack underwater. I mean, they have a little bit more of underwater time than Langen right now. And this is because what happened, if you are the defending team, normally you have to stay on the rhythm of the attacker team. And Akaren has been attacking a little bit more. So that brings you your game out of the rhythm and out of press. And that's why we see that when we are... more under pressure than Akaren. That's the little... you know, the difference.
Little bit that makes a difference,
yeah.
Yes. So, we're getting close to the second half here. We will see a game of, again, 15 minutes in the semifinals here.
200 viewers, over 200 viewers.
I think we will have a lot of visitors on our live stream from Germany. Hallo deutsche Fans von Langen, Grüße aus Berlin. Es fühlt sich fast ein bisschen komisch an, jetzt Deutsch zu sprechen hier. Ich hoffe, ihr habt die erste Halbzeit genauso genossen wie wir in dem Spiel Langen gegen Akaren. Und natürlich ist unser Herz mit Langen in diesem genialen Rugby-Spiel, das wir hier sehen. Beide Teams sind auf Augenhöhe. Und es macht einfach sehr viel Spaß zuzuschauen. So, genießt die zweite Hälfte. So, we're back in the second half here. And Akaren is in ball possession, and Langen is now playing on the left side, and Akaren on the right. And Akaren is in a close corner, but a ball pass was intercepted by Langen. That's what we've seen before. The pass game between the players of Akaren is not that precise, and it's easy for Langen to intercept them. And now Langen is undisturbed, almost at the basket of Akaren, and building up their attack. And here we go. We have two players from Langen now going down. One is on the ball carriers on the open side, trying to break free, but she lost the ball. It's a call from the referee, holding without ball, free throw against Langen. This interrupts the attack of Langen and gives Akaren the chance to build up their attack. This is dangerous, what we've seen before. Akaren is quite aggressive on the basket of Langen, and this game could be decided by the next goal if the other team scores and manages to build a fortress around with defense and don't let anything go through. So let's see what's going on. We have Akaren attacking heavily on the basket of Langen, but Langen manages to break free with the ball, get the ball and break free. We have now a fighting, forechecking in the middle of the pool. Two players, one from Akaren and one from Langen, fighting around the ball, cluster on the surface, but it's fast dissolved and the ball is free again. Akaren swimming on the surface to the close corner of the Langen basket, and Langen is in defense. They're ready for the attack of Akaren. And the forechecking is very good from Langen here. Langen already is in ball possession, but tackled. The Langen player is tackled by three Akaren players, and Akaren manages to break free with the ball. And we have now an attack from the open side, but not a very precise pass down to the player waiting at the basket. And now Langen is in ball position. The ball was again lost by Akaren, but the Akaren forechecking in the middle field is amazing. They don't give Langen the space they need to swim through the pool. They are stopped at least 4 meters, 3 meters in front of the Akaren basket before they are even able to establish their attack pattern. But nevertheless, Langen tries to punch through this wall of Akaren players. And here we are at the basket of Akaren on a higher level, eye to eye with the goalkeeper. But the ball is lost. The Langen player tries to play through to her player waiting at the close side. But the ball is lost. Akaren recovered it, lost it to the Langen again. And we're back at least 2 meters in front of the Akaren basket, right in front of it, on the bottom of the pool. And again, we only see two players of Langen down at the basket, and there seem to be twice as much Akaren players there. Now we have an attack from the open side, trying to go over the goalie to the close side, but the Langen players cannot really... this is a chance! The goal was open and empty, but the
it's amazing
player,
the reaction of the Akaren player.
The Akaren player realized the situation and tackled the player from Langen away, so she couldn't just drop in the ball. It would have been an easy goal, but very good reaction from Akaren meant we are still with Langen attacking the basket of Akaren here. Now Langen takes a little bit of a distance from the goal of Akaren. They try to build from the attack from the close side. The forechecking of Akaren is not that heavy anymore. And there was a bad pass from Langen in the nowhere, recovered by an Akaren player who swims to the corner of the close side of the Langen basket. And now her teammates are already in place around the basket. And Akaren tries to build their attack from the close side. A lot of players now around the Langen basket on the bottom. The ball is tackled up to the surface, And there's a cluster, and Langen tries to push away the cluster in direction of their Karen. The ball drops down in the hands of Langen, and forechecking of a Karen starts immediately. Langen does not have a chance to even to go an inch forward, without fighting. So this is both teams do a very good job to stop the offense counterattack of the other team in the middle of the pool before they can even establish a massive counterattack. So now we are back at the Akaren basket, and coming from the close side, Langen player already down at the basket waiting, but the forechecking of Akaren is really impenetrable. Langen has a difficult time reaching the basket, not by swimming and not by passing. And now we have a cluster on the surface here, right above the Akaren basket. And this is now Langen player goes in, but it's massive how Akaren stops every attempt from Langen to build up a coordinated attack pattern. And I don't see how you can break this massive...
Well, you need to keep coming in wave with three players like right now. If Langen could do like this three or four times, then maybe...
But there was a wrong pass and to the wrong person in the game from Langen, and Akaren recovered the ball. And we're now back at the side on the basket of Langen, and we have an attack in the middle of the basket on the bottom, and they try to go in and push the goalkeeper up, but well, the defense of Langen also is quite good, but I have to say, compared to the Akaren defense, Langen leaves more holes and gaps for Akaren to have possibilities to score here.
Akaren plays very smart. They go with the ball up and try to play the ball down. There's always a player who can receive the ball. So basically their ball control around the goal is much stronger.
Call and from the referee and a free throw against Langen.
So they try to establish this game. They have two options underwater to play to. I would recommend not to go in any cluster if you want to win the game. But this is, of course, a physical game, and it's an immense forechecking. But in order to win the game, either teams have to have more ladies under the water, under the bottom, to win and to have the options for passing and doing that. So you could see when Langen established the good position offense play, they are in a good situation. They put pressure on the goal, and Kati almost scored on the empty basket. So this has to be continued, fast attacks, four in and out on the goal on a continuous. So push the goalkeeper in front, establish a strong middle position would help.
Jörg, even you sound excited.
No, I want to stay focused on the game.
We
have again a cluster on the surface,
six minutes
to go. So they should try to avoid that. Better do open forechecking, go to the ball and
move
the ball fast. So a cluster on the surface is no ball movement. It's just... time losing in the game. So we have 5:45. So
I could imagine that they're a bit tired because they've been a very fast-paced game. So,
but
yeah.
I don't think they don't. Both teams don't look tired, but
no.
The cluster on the surface is always a sign for depleted energy, and you deplete more energy even if the cluster. So now Akaren is. This is one more of these strange passes from Akaren. They play
actually
in the field.
That are not strange passes. That is there.
There's
where
line,
you
yeah.
there you put the ball there where your teammate should be.
Should
yeah.
be. But
so
but
and then
Langen, but Langen is there.
The
yeah, but this is in more than 50% this work out.
Yeah.
So, and we're watching the game, Willy. Yes, I know. So Langen is an attack, so they come from the close side up to the middle. A little bit, not too much pressure pass, recovered by Akarin. Akarin in the middle in a cluster underwater, counter attack with three.
And
now depends. The pass goes on the open side, but the defense stands, go back on the middle. They can try to control the ball.
From my point of view, Akarin is more aggressive on the Langen basket than Langen is on the Akarin basket, and has more chances to score here. And this is really dangerous.
I don't
see
they have chances to score, but at least they control the position and they make passes which goes from one side in a very narrow space with a lot of defense. And this is somehow looks more aggressive, but it's not really effective at the moment.
But they have more chances than Langen does right now.
They put high pressure, that's for sure. But the passes go there, the ball control is there, still there, and going down. So now Langen player controls the ball, but don't go to the surface. Where's your players?
To make the pass so they can still
So you have to release the pressure from your own defense in order to get the ball out of the game.
We have 3 minutes 20 left here in this second half. It's 1-1 UC Langen from Germany against Akarin from Norway Champions Cup 2016. And this game is two times 15 minutes. And if they don't have a winner in the next 3 minutes, we will see penalties or a penalty shootout. So again, a quick cluster. Ball is dropping down, call from the referee, holding without ball, free throw against Akarin.
So less than 3 minutes, so now Langen need to put all the pressure, take the whole time and try to score in this. But Akarin forechecked the
So now we have Akarin and an attack, and Langen had all the players in position to defend, but there's a pass coming down and the attacker from Akarin is on the goalie. She's pulled up by two Langen players. Now they have they're fighting for the ball on the surface right on top of the basket of the Langen team. It's 2 minutes right now until the end of the game, and they should get that ball out of there. Don't give Akarin another chance to get closer, because these girls know what they're doing, and small mistake, you know, could be the score. They just passed the ball, the Akarin player just saw it is two against the back of the goalie of Langen, the three of them, but the defender really make a good job of fighting for the ball and bringing those attackers away from the basket. That was a little bit of a more risky situation than they had before. And it's 1.5 minutes, and Akarin is coming with everything they have. So they have Langen has to concentrate, focus, and get the ball out of there, because we have seen it. There's still time for them on this attack to score. 1 minute and 17 seconds.
Akarin always attack from the surface and push the ball down on the one side down. And more than 50% of the time, the ball really reaches the teammate. So this is really something which is looks easy, but it's not at all. So we have one minute free throw against Akarin, so that will be
probably the last chance.
The last chance of Yil Langen, and so.
And Akarin knows this.
No time. I guess no time to wait on the surface anymore.
But the truth is, Akarin knows this, and they will do everything to stop the attack of Langen, and probably do a counterattack, or like we see, have a cluster and wait the time to go into the.
No, Akarin is not the type to do a cluster
but
and
if
wait.
If you're in the last seconds, now we have a counterattack.
They have a counterattack with five players underwater. So impressive. 15 seconds to go.
So this is the last chance of Akarin.
9, 8,
that
7.
That was an impressive counterattack.
6.
Yeah, but sadly, don't say sadly, but with no use.
Out.
It was from what we've seen.
We could see the strengths of both teams.
Yes,
the defense
the
and the defense in the first half. The attack from Langen for the scoring goal was excellent, with two goals from once from the open side. One is able to block the other. The defense, the attack was perfectly performed. So this was really exciting.
Yes.
So we had a question here from Jan on Facebook. Why we don't have more interview partners? The thing is, we have only a 3-minute break between the games, and if we do interviews, we will totally go into these.
Into
the games, and we want to stay into the games. And actually, the teams playing here and leaving the pool area at once, and it would be the most interesting thing to interview the team captains. But the team captains want to stay with their team, and when they leave the pool area, if we get them and sit them down here, it's annoyance for them. They're in their concentration, and for us, it's difficult to ask all the questions we want to ask in the 3 minutes we have in between the games. And if you interview them in the game, we don't do what we should do, comment the games for those who may be just listening. And we have big feedback in the last years from people watching the live stream who told us, very nice the interviews, thank you very much, but please stay in the games. Sometimes we are listening on mobile devices, and we want to know what's happening in the game, and it's interesting to have interviews, but it's more important for us. We want to know what's going on in the live stream.
So now it would be interesting. It will be a very mental related result. Based on my experience with the experience of Langen, they should win this.
Do you know of the penalty capability of a Karin?
I don't care. I care the capability of my national players, and I would do. They should score in the first part, and I guess when Kati will do the first one and score, and then Laura will
hold the
second one, and then it's over. That's my guess.
Yeah, I think too. It's in favor of Langen now, because the potential
Langen.
We have Langen. Langen, in favor of Langen, because the potential they have of the experience with these player in penalties. Let's see.
We don't see the underwater thing. It's already on the run.
Can we have the underwater camera, please?
Underwater camera.
No. Okay.
Okay. Kart is attacking and goal. Oh, we came to the right time. As I said, from the top. Kati with the strong arms get close to the neck of the goalkeeper, and easy goal.
So
50% of my first prediction is right. So now I hope Laura make me also.
Let's see what the Karin has in store in an attacking.
I hope Laura keep this.
Here we go. Penalty shootout against
Laura.
Laura is on the goal, and the Karin player is behind her, tries to be around her. Whoa! Well done by Karin.
Well.
It's always the risky part if the goalkeeper leaves the goal and. It's with the back, it's and you don't have the control to the ball
anymore. Yeah.
It's almost over. So that was the wrist, the speculation to get the ball. And
so I think what I saw, the Akarin player has the same capability as the Langen player.
Yeah.
So this shootout will be interesting. Now back again. Akarin is on the basket, and Langen is attacking. And the Langen player tries to swim through the fins of the Karin player, who keeps her away quite good. And now the Langen player is down on the bottom of the basket, but the Karin player was lying right where she should be, between her and
18,
the basket.
18 seconds to go.
And now a Karin player is keeping the Langen player away with her fins.
10 seconds.
It's astonishing.
Four seconds. 4 seconds.
This was a close call, and
I think this was Kupi. She did the very relaxed and keep focused. Don't be oppressed, and used 41 seconds in order to.
But I'm quite astonished how much the Langen player did swim into the fins of the Karen defender, because normally you can, if you go over the head, you're out of the reach of the fins.
But
it was difficult, was quite
okay.
Good. Now we go again, Langen on the basket, and Karen attacking. Karen coming from above, ripping away the goalkeeper, but she managed to go back to the goal and goal. Wow. This like I expected, both teams are really at the same level of experience and capability.
El juego de Castores es en 3 horas, a las 2:30 hora europea. Sorry, a question about what time Castores is playing.
So now Laura attacks.
So now Karen is again on the basket.
Oh, that was attacked to the mask, I mean.
And the Langen player tries to pull her away from the basket, going up to the surface again.
30 seconds.
But you know, they are doing what I mentioned yesterday. You always have to be between the basket and the
ball.
Yes,
they are doing exactly. They
are
very experienced. Yeah. See exactly what you do when I attack. And now we go. She's coming from above, but the Karen player is quite good. The ball is lost, falling down. The Karen is almost in possession of a ball, but both
seven
they are clinging
seconds,
it.
Six.
We are on the...
Okay,
surface.
Akaren.
Akaren saved this penalty. Very well done by Akaren. A little bit astonished. But very well done by Akaren. Good work from a goalie. She showed
that
the
that's
right.
That's referee discussion. Let's see.
They were discussing. If she was in on ball control, if she was controlling the...
So now it will be tough situation. Akaren is an advantage. They protect the goal, so if they now score it...
Here we go. Akaren is attacking. Goalkeeper from Langen is on the basket and doing the right thing. Always stay between the goal and... That should be, looks like Kati, and she's the most experienced player here in this game. The Karen player tries to get in. Whoa.
So, okay. Karen just won the game 4-3. Langen has lost two games already.
I'm impressed by the capabilities of Akaren here in these penalties. I'm not.
They're very, very experienced. They're very good players.
We are talking on the top level of underwater rugby.
Yeah.
Sure.
And they used all their chances they got, and they did this way, in a very routine thing. And I'm really impressed. So. That means, if I'm not wrong in the calculation, Langen has third place.
Correct.
So that means we will see the match-winning game between
Akaren and Castores. Yes.
So between. That is almost the one game to the last, and then it will be decided. We have the Champions Cup for the ladies goes to Colombia or again to Norway.
It was a close call for Langen, and they showed very they unfolded what we said before this game they unfolded their potential in this game against the Karen, and it was quite great. Now we see Winne doing his didgeridoo
because of Australia
they are playing. Australia was warming up outside of the pool in the open air, and Winne was going out. We had this on video, doing his didgeridoo. He has a didgeridoo. He's producing didgeridoos and selling them. He's a very good player. He loves Australia, spends a lot of time in his holidays there. So he's super happy to have an Australian team here playing his didgeridoo. And all the Australians were smiling.
Yeah, they say now he will die.
Because?
Because now Zurich is playing
against
Australia.
Of the game. So Jan, please stay with us. Don't die now. wait until the game is over, please, 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 please. Everything is
so
fine.
So, well, I want also to congratulate Langen on the third place of the cup, and also
yes.
If Akaren wins, I mean they. Have